dropping banger after banger.
Bring it on now!
This is
DJ Southern Comfort.
Howdy, folks. Welcome to another edition of DJ Southern Comfort. Getting ready for another gig. This one's going to be a good one. It's going to be a disco prom in Jonesboro, Texas. Initially, I was going to use a facade, just a standard facade. But, you know, I wasn't feeling it. I'll show you why. I was going to put some lights all around it, make it sparkle, make it nice and bright. And, you know, I think it'll still look cool. But I've been wanting to do this for a while, so I went ahead and purchased a 65-inch TV that Walmart had. Very inexpensive, $350-$360, I think it was. And, well, there it is right there. I went to the lumber shop and I bought some lumber. I'm gonna build a rolling case for it. And I wanna use it as a digital facade. Virtual DJ, for those of you who use Virtual DJ, it has a lot of good visualizations, and you can play videos, you can do screenshots, you can do all kinds of stuff. You can write text messages. So I think I'm going to tap into that. I've used it a long time ago, but it's been a while. I've been using Virtual DJ since about 2001, but I haven't used it in a while. So I think we're going to do that. We're going to put that together, and we're going to go from this for the disco party. Something really cool, and I'll show you guys later on what it looks like. I'm not going to show you the building process because that's not that type of video, but you'll get the gist of it, and I can list the materials, or you can PM me and ask me for the materials and what I use, and you know, if you decide you want to do something similar to it. I'm all about being different. That's why I don't use facades. I think it's DJ Too Legit. He spoke about that the other day, and I agree with him. Everybody has facades. Everybody looks the same with their little lights blinking here and there, you know. So I like to be different. I built my DJ console. It's got its own set of lights in it. And now I'm going to have this digital facade that I'll have an option to use it. Because like DJ Too Legit says, it's all about options, baby. So stay tuned, man. It's going to be cool. Here are all the goodies that I got to build this digital facade. And hopefully we're going to turn all this into something cool. Something portable, easy to move, plug and play. That's my motto. Hell, that should be my DJ name, plug and play. And that right there. The black paint is standard camo black paint. You know, rednecks like to use camo paint. And then I got some Raptor liner coming in. It'll be here tomorrow. And I'm going to Raptor liner the case. I'm going to give it a fine mist of Raptor liner. Give it like a little sandy look to it. It should look pretty good. I'll show you guys the product in a little bit. I told y'all I'd be putting something together to make a digital facade. So this is what we've come up so far. Still got a little bit of work to do. Still got some material left. And of course, that cheap Walmart 65-inch TV. It's all about the budget, buddy. Stay tuned. And through the magic of television, here is almost the final product. All we have left to do now is sand it down, fill in a couple cracks with some wood putty, paint it black, and then when my Raptor liner comes in today, we'll Raptor liner the outer areas and make them look nice and cool and custom built. Yes, I have to put some weights on this end. That's just temporary. I got some 10-pound dumbbells. I'm going to strap them on there somehow. Because if not, the weight of the TV, it'll flip over and then you gonna have to do another trip to Walmart. Hopefully get another cheap TV. But everything fits well. It rolls really easy. It's nice and sturdy. And the only way to kind of weight the weight of the TV so it doesn't flip forward is to extend the legs forward, but then that will look kind of, I think that will look kind of goofy and it defeats the purpose, so. All right, folks, I just got done spraying the last coat of Raptor liner. I bought the Raptor liner that comes in a spray can. Very easy to use, comes out really nice. I don't know if you can see the texture, but it looks really, really nice. I use one can. You gotta activate it, do all kinds of stuff to it to get it to work, but it's worth it. Also used the sprayable Raptor liner. I've used it on my trailer, and I painted my son-in-law's complete truck with it, and it came out really nice. It's been like 4 years, and it still looks great. So this Raptor liner stuff, I'm not getting paid to say this, but it's real good stuff. You can buy the tintable stuff. You can tint it any color you want, pretty much. But anyways, this is what it looks like, my digital DJFAK. Now let's get ready for the prom. All right, folks. Here I am putting everything together now. Today is Tuesday. We got the disco prom on Saturday, so I'm starting to get everything charged up, testing all my equipment, making sure everything is good to go. The digital facade is finished. I did have to do some spot painting on the inside that I missed. When I flipped it over, I could tell I missed it. So I went ahead and touched it up. So I'm letting it dry a little bit. But basically, this thing here is going to have that 65-inch TV inside. I'm probably going to put some LEDs down here in the bottom and run them across where they dance to the music on the floor and just give it a little bit more pop. And then this thing here just basically slides in to my other DJ console, so I have options. I can use either my regular DJ console, which has lights all in there, or I can just roll this bad boy back in. It fits perfectly, matched against it. Of course, I'll have to center it. And I'll have a digital display. I can do monograms, I can do just music visualizations. I can input information and put it out, you know, happy birthday, whatever. And this is how it looks. My console fits perfectly in between the support legs. And I think that's pretty neat, clean, easy. And again, plug and play. I like that word, plug and play. And just like that, we got everything hooked up. Everything is finished. Got Virtual DJ doing his thing. I got it set for some kind of bubble, trippy, built-in visualizer. I think it came out really nice. Don't have sound going right now because I ain't hooked up any of my speakers. That'll be my next test. We're getting ready for the prom Saturday. I got my lovely assistants here. DJ Baby Spice. She's making sure everything is charged up. Getting everything prepped. Dongles are charged up. And of course, now we got our digital facade. So, this is what it looks like. It just rolls in, rolls out. I just ordered a customized cover to cover it when it's being transported. It's going to have some padding in the front to protect the screen. The screen is locked in with a wall mount, a fixed wall mount. I got two 15-pound weights on the end here to counterbalance it. I'm going to zippy tie them and just leave them there. And I'm thinking about getting some kind of black boards and just closing the back of the ends there. to just give it that finished look. Of course, you see the back, you see some lights flashing off, but that's the lighting built into my console. It's sound reactive right now. And basically I have some LEDs, and then I have a RF1 in there that syncs to all my lights whenever I'm DJing, so my console moves with everything else. All right, if you guys like it, man, drop your comments below. Good or bad, I don't care. I'm always, you know, there's always room for improvement. We think it turned out pretty nice. I just got some LEDs coming in tomorrow to go on the bottom of the case. They're going to reflect off the floor just to give it a little bit more pop whenever everything is turned off. And that's pretty much it. I want to show you one more thing. I can switch this to a slideshow. And if I do a slideshow right now, I have my logo and I have the monogram I put together for the prom. Of course, I'm going to take my logo off and move it to a different folder for the prom. I don't need to be displaying my logo. But, you know, it's options you have. And I think they're going to give me a bunch of pictures of the kids, the graduating class. And we're going to put them in a slideshow, and I'm going to play them in between the songs and stuff. And that should be interesting to see them see themselves in the screen. And then, of course, I'm going to have their monogram displayed on a wall. Probably a 10 by 10 or 12 by 12 doing this thing right there. All right, stay tuned. We got some more prom stuff coming up. Got my monogram set up behind me. Yeah, that's a school monogram that they wanted for the prom. It's all custom made by yours truly. I will display that on the wall. I can display it on the floor, wherever it's suitable. Got all my music ready. Got my crates ready. I got a prom clean crate ready. All the music in it is clean. That's what you're just listening to now. I also have a new disco crate. Basically, I grabbed all the new disco crates from Crate Hackers. I put them all in one folder, and I'll mix them at my leisure. And I also have a disco crate, which got all the classics and probably about 9 hours worth of disco on it. Hours we'll be heading out to Jonesboro, Texas to get that done. But as you can see here, I got everything ready to go. All right, just got done uploading the trailer. Sun's shining bright today, so you probably got a little glare. Sorry for that. Everything is loaded. Took us about 15 minutes. Bobby, real smooth. Experience, and I knew this going in because we're in Texas and that's the way it is. It was a disco theme prom. Not sure who picked that. According to them, it was the students. However, it turned into a country honky-tonk type of prom. And if you see on the videos, that's basically what I played most of the night. I started off with some disco, some new disco. I threw in some of the new regular popular songs. Had some reaction to it, but not really the type of reaction, you know, as a DJ you expect. So I immediately pivoted to one or two country songs, and that really kicked off the party. Now, mind you, that this is a very small school district, JISD. I think the senior class was like 20, and about another 20 juniors. So all in all, they probably had about maybe 75, 80 people there, including the chaperones and the staff. So very small group. Those groups that tend to be, for the most part, very hard to DJ for because they all feel a little timid because it's not a big volume of people dancing. So, but once I kicked off and pivoted to the country music, which is my forte, is my background, that changed the whole atmosphere and it turned into a pretty decent little honky-tonk prom. The first clue when people were walking in is most of the senior class, all the males were wearing Stetsons. If you don't know what a Stetson is, it's a cowboy hat. So that pretty much told me and my wife mentioned to me, this is going to be a country dance. I'm like, yep, I think so. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, the log. The video screen did great. I had a lot of good comments about it. You know, I had the school logo displaying, and I had some psychedelic stuff going on when I first started playing disco. Very easy to roll around, move around, and get it to where I need to, plug and play. That's our word again. And I got another project coming up. I'm getting tired of carrying my speaker totems one by one. I mean, they are pretty heavy. So next project is gonna be, and I'll show you right there, it's gonna be a speaker totem cart. And I already got the materials here. I'm waiting on the wheels from Amazon. And as soon as it comes together, our next video log, we're gonna go ahead and feature this new totem where we can just roll it in and roll it out into the trailer and to wherever the venue is, and let's eliminate some of the back issues. So guys, stay tuned. If you like what we're doing, pre-subscribe to YouTube, or you can follow us at Facebook at DJ Southern Comfort. I'll be more than happy to answer any questions. And then we're gonna start, after next week, we're gonna start doing a series of videos of the equipment we have and what we use and so forth, and hopefully help some of the aspiring DJs out there to start building their systems. Next weekend, I'm gonna be DJing again at Bo's Barn Dance Hall in Temple, Texas. And hopefully I'll see some of you guys there. You guys have a great, great day.
The hottest DJ in the city.
In the city.
Live in the mix. It's the one.
It's the one and only.
DJ Southern Comfort.